Greetings, couch potatoes. Welcome back for another episode of Let's Play The Last of Us Remastered with Dude Long Couch. We're in the hotel lobby. There are some kids screaming outside. Not because they're being eaten by zombies. At least I don't think so. Pretty sure they're just playing. Which is a fine juxtaposition with Ellie here, who is in kind of a crappy mood ever since we yelled at her for saving our lives. And now we are tasked with moving forward. Just got past one of the creepiest parts of the game. I'm glad that that's behind us. Come on, Ellie, keep up. I think there's a... I'm trying to remember exactly where. There's some kind of collectible somewhere.
Get back out. Find that bridge.
Tell me where you go.
I hate this crap.
She's just gonna be a little shithead for a little while. That's okay, though. Stick with the brick. Ellie, where are you? She's still hanging out up there? Ah, whatever. She'll take care of herself. Let's check out the restroom. Sometimes there's interesting things in here. Mirrors are broken. I always like checking out the mirrors in video games, seeing the reflection tech. I don't know why, it always kind of fascinates me that they can, like, make a mirror in a video game. Doesn't make any sense at all. It's probably, like, really easy to do, but it's one of those things that's just, like, it seems really cool to me. Ooh, Firefly pendant. That's not the collectible I was thinking of, though. Colby Reed. Okay, I guess that's all we got in here. So for being on hard mode, I'm actually doing fairly awesome as far as supplies go. I'm kind of surprised, actually. See, explosive powder's still full. What can I make? I've got 3 shivs. What's my melee weapon? I think I'm... I do have a bat. Well, that wouldn't help me get rid of my explosive powder. Let's make a nail bomb. So I can pick that up. Oh, knock over. Wait a second, this wet floor sign. You gonna tell me that wet floor sign has been standing for like 20 years? And now I come along and knock it over? Where do you get off, Joel? Jesus. Okay, good there. And she's still just, like, lounging against the wall, holding her arm, because she's got an attitude. I don't blame her, though. Oh, upgrade manual. What'd I get? Melee weapons upgraded. Modifications last 1 hit longer. That is so, so super duper helpful. Quite happy that I found that. Prom 2013. This does not look like a prom I want to go to. Looks like everything got pretty fucked up. Oh, I think there's a conversation here.
Wow, look at that.
Yes.
I say a backdrop. People would take their pictures in front of it.
Yeah, I know what it is.
Okay then. Something on your mind, Ellie?
I wasn't trying to disobey you back there. You were taking a really long time, and I thought maybe he's gotten into trouble.
Look, it don't matter what you thought. I need you to listen to me.
I do. It's just that... Whatever, Joel.
Yeah, but if she had listened to you, you probably would have gotten murdered, because you were not winning that engagement, Joel. You can kind of see the roots of their like father-daughter relationship starting to kind of take root there.
That door looks like a way out. Hey, you see a way to get up there?
Nope.
How like Ellie is, like, completely and utterly right in this scenario, but Joel will never admit it because it would be, like, kind of, like, compromising his authority on her. I think that's a father-daughter thing to do. Hold on a second. Yeah, I don't know what that accomplishes. Oh, I can do it again. How many times can I do that? I'm surprised there's not like a hidden line of dialogue or something in there. Oh, I just saw something glowing over here. Let me just... Is that a brick? Yep, just a brick. Okay, so we're gonna push this piano over. If it'll let me. There we go.
Alright. Damn, this is easier than I thought. Hey, how about a hand?
You sure you can trust me with that?
Ellie.
Alright, I know you're mad, but let's not be a smart ass, Ellie.
Push harder!
There, how's that?
Let's go.
I'm surprised she doesn't need my help to climb up here. That's a pretty high jump for someone of her height. Ellie's got mad ups. It's too bad she was born now. She might have missed her calling as a WNBA player. And I swear to God, I think I missed something. I know that there's a comic book somewhere around here. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. I think I missed a collectible somewhere back in that last area. I don't remember exactly where it was. I just remember it happening right after that cutscene. Not a big deal, though. I was never going to get 100% of those things, to be honest with you. But if you're following along, just know that it is back there somewhere.
Oh, shit. Come here, keep your head down. Right now, I'm gonna jump down there and I'm gonna clear us a path.
What about me?
You stay here.
This is so stupid. We'd have more of a fucking chance if you let me help.
I am. You seem to know your way around a gun. You reckon you can handle that?
Well, I sort of shot a rifle before. But it was at rats.
Rats?
With BBs.
Well, it's the same basic concept. Lift it up. All right, now. You're going to lean right into that stock, because it is going to kick a hell of a lot more than any baby rifle.
Okay.
Go and pull the bolt back. Grab it right there. Just tug it. There you go. And as soon as you fire, you're going to want to get another round in there quick. Listen to me. If I get into trouble down there, you make every shot count. Yeah?
I got this.
All right. And just so we're clear about back there, it was either him or me.
Joel coming around.
You're welcome.
Awesome. I love that part. Asshole should have known better.
You better make sure you get away with it. Right? I would have been.
They're all dead! They're all fucking dead!
What the hell's he yapping about? Take a breath. Who's dead?
The whole crew. The 76 lookout guy. Some fucking tourist killed him. Kill all of them.
Shit. You talk to the boss?
Yeah. He wants everyone to hold their ground. Watch the gate.
All right. You heard him. Search the area. Do not let anybody through.
Okay, guys. So this is a massive kind of sandboxy combat section of fun and awesomeness. The really cool part about this part is that if you fuck up, which I almost certainly will, because there's just too much going on here to do this perfectly, Ellie will actually start taking shots at the enemies for us. And I've had it go both ways as far as her skill level. Sometimes she's like a deadly assassin with that fucking rifle, just takes out everybody for you. And sometimes she doesn't do fuck all. She misses everything and just generally sucks shit. Okay, I just wanted to get behind this car so I can finish choking this guy out. But yeah, that part, this part in the story right here is maybe one part where I would say it felt a little rushed, how quickly Joel came around on that whole concept. Because just like 5 minutes ago, he was admonishing her for even daring to touch a gun. And now he's like, hey, instead of a pistol, why don't you just take this huge fucking rifle and that you've never really shot before and, you know, go ahead and watch my back with it. But I like it. And then he just jumps down like fucking Batman to take these guys out. There's just so many guys in this part, though. It's pretty much a... If you can do this part perfectly, hats off to you, because you got bigger chops than I do. I know at some point I'm gonna fuck this up. Okay, those guys are both going upstairs. What? The hell was that? Oh, I guess because they could see me from up there. I'm not going to worry too much about collecting stuff right now. There's a lot in this area to collect as far as supplies and whatnot, but right now I'm just worried about... This is probably a really bad spot to be. If this guy walks in here... Okay, but he's not. Okay, now's my chance to get this guy, I think. Surprise, bitch. Okay. Some kind of, like, meat locker or something back here. Some dead guys. A note. We don't need the fireflies. Sure, they might. I don't really have time to read this right now. You guys can go ahead and pause it and read that if you want. I don't think it's anything super important. But I just don't want to get spotted while I'm doing that right now. I should really get back out in the open, that way if I do fuck up, Ellie can actually cover me. Because as it is, she's not going to be able to shoot in here. Oh look, and you can see her on your detective mode. Way up top there. That's cool. I'm surprised nobody's found any corpses yet. Didn't I choke a guy out? Oh shit. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, I thought I choked a guy out right in the middle over there. I guess nobody's gone back that way, though. So that's cool. Okay, here we go. I gotta time this out perfectly. That set him off, didn't it? Fuck, fuck, fuck. So that right there is one thing that really does bother me about this game. That dude never uttered a word and never had time to alert his buddies or do anything, but it still put everybody on alert. I feel like, oh, give me that. I feel like that's one thing that Batman Arkham Knight actually did really well. The fact that if somebody saw you, you still had like a split second to get a stealth kill off on them before they could alert everybody, which is a lot more realistic. If you surprise a guy, like, even, you know, even if a guy's on alert, if he sees you, it's going to take him at least a second or so to actually... Okay, okay. Oh, shit. Woohoo. Okay. How many more guys we got here? There's at least two. Shit. Alright, let's get outside. Let's come back over this way. Come on, Ellie.
What you got, man? Let's go!
Fucking hell! Who's shooting at me? Okay, I guess there's more guys than I thought. I was hoping they were the last two, but they're not. Oh, fuck! Jesus Christ on a cracker. I gotta heal up. Okay. I told you guys it was all gonna go to shit eventually. That's the fucker that threw the Molotov at me, I think. Okay, there's two more. Oh god, there's a fucking shitload more coming. No! Don't shoot me, bro. Jesus, titty fucking Christ. No! Oh my god! How did I die that quickly? Who was shooting me? Okay, I totally forgot that there was like a second round of guys that were gonna come out. That makes this extremely difficult.
Hey, talk to me.
That game over may have worked out in my favor though. Only because kind of reset everything. Played that guy. Oh shit. Oh shit, his buddy's right there. Hurry up, Joel, hurry up.
Holy shit.
Fuck. Oh, did Ellie take him out? Oh, I think she did. That's nice. All right, time to get the high ground. Make sure there's nobody out here. I'd really love to take some of these guys out with the bow, thin out the ranks stealthily without alerting them to where I am. Oh, this is gonna be a long shot. Okay, I think I missed him, but I think Ellie got him. Oh shit, there's a guy right there.
Where'd he go?
Ellie, you should really shoot this guy standing right here. Yeah, that a girl! That a girl! Oh, that's awesome. I'm so happy. Oh, I see you coming, shithead. Yeah, come on, step over here. I got something for you. Where is this asshole? Seriously? Don't turn around, don't turn around. Sneaky, sneaky. Oh, shit! That was really close. But I got him at the last second. Yeah, dick. Okay. See the last one?
All right, come on down.
Thank you, Lord.
How'd I do?
Pretty damn good, I'd say. The second time around, anyway.
Something a little more your size. It's for emergencies only.
Okay.
Now, the safety's on. Do you know how to switch it off?
I do.
You gotta respect it. This is not...
Joel, I'll be careful.
Okay.
Awesome. So now Ellie has a pistol, which she will use in combat. But nice thing is that she never does it on her own. She'll never, like, alert enemies on your behalf. She only does it when you are, you know, already engaged in combat. And I don't know if they actually counted that health kit I used. I don't even remember how many I had. I think they probably did, because I think I must have had two, right? So that kind of sucks. But I guess it wouldn't be hard mode if it was too easy. And let's go ahead and make some more of those so I can pick up this crap. I know that one guy dropped a Molotov up there, but I'm full on those. That's actually one way that, you know, you could have started this battle right there in the beginning when you're crouched behind that wall and there's like four of them there. It does kind of make sense to start it off by chucking a Molotov or a nail bomb in there. But obviously if you do that, you're giving yourself away right away. And I kind of wanted to see how far I could get being stealthy. You guys all saw how well that worked out for me. But only having to restart this section once isn't the worst thing ever. Because it's a fairly difficult section, just with the amount of dudes in it. And, I'm not sure how many game overs that is for me in total, but I think I'm doing pretty well overall, all things considered. Now, if memory serves me, there might actually be some kind of trap over in this area. I think there's like a line somewhere, like an explosive wire set up. I might be making that up, but I kind of like instinctually avoided this whole side for most of that battle. Yeah, maybe I did make that up. Who knows? Okay, that right there is the way forward. Ooh, finding parts out the ass. And I also gotta say, I'm a little upset that my bow hasn't been killing dudes in one shot. It might be because they usually know where I am by the time I'm shooting it at them. I guess it works a lot better as a like a one-hit kill when they like if they don't see it coming. It might be that kind of mechanic. So I should probably test out that theory. I don't know if it's that or if I'm just getting super unlucky with my shots. And I just want to come up here and circle around real quick. That Molotov disappeared, but that's okay. Can't remember if there's anything over... Oh, you know what? Yes, this room in here. I remember the last time I played this game, I did almost this entire section from in here. I don't know if it always works out that way, but like there was one dude walking around in here, so I came in and stealthily took him out. And then I would just crouch behind one of these desks, and like one by one they would just pop in to see what was going on, but they never came like, you know, full force all at once. They just one by one came in and I picked them all off stealthily. So that might be a good tactic if you're having trouble with this section. Anyway, I believe that is all of the stuff that we want. There are some grilled rats here if you're hungry. I'm gonna pass on that. I do actually need some food pretty soon, but I'm not big on grilled rats personally.
Do your thing, Ellie.
On it. Stupid chain is stuck. Hold on.
I am.
There.
It's good thinking.
Good job, Ellie. Now, if we want to, I guess we can move this out so that they can't follow us.
Help me open this.
Here.
I got it.
I'm not entirely sure if I've ever done that before, to be honest with you guys. I don't know what the point of it is, other than to make yourself feel safe. You have something to talk about over here? She kind of looks like she had something to say. But if you notice now that we've let her have a gun and we trust her a little bit more, she's not acting so bitchy anymore. As far as like her animations and, you know, stuff like that. Actually, I guess I must have done that before because I think we need this to climb up here. So never mind. I forgot that we needed it to come over here. Come on. Alright, fuck it. I'll just do it head on. I was gonna make it flush so it was easier to climb, but turns out that's completely unnecessary. And a waste of time. Alright. Pills, workbench. Let's check the pill situation right quick. Only 15. Yikes. So, you can get level 3 listen mode at 50. I don't think we're gonna go for that right away. I think we're gonna come down and do Weapon Sway and Shiv Master before we do anything else. Healing speed and crafting speed I almost never go for. I can see how they're useful, especially in, you know, a situation like the one I was just in, where I had to heal really quick in the middle of battle. But you can see even then, it didn't really make a difference to anything. So we've got 271 parts. I'd really love to find more tools. Man, that would be cool. But let's do draw speed on the bow. I'm going all in on this bow thing, guys. I want to try and make this weapon like really badass in this playthrough. And I want to try and get better at doing stealth kills with it. I don't know if that's going to work out in my favor or not, but I just really want to try it. And let's see, I don't have a ton of ammo for this weapon. They took away the shots that I fucking picked up for it, even though they, you know, took away the health kit that I used too. They didn't let me keep the fucking bullets I picked up. I'm assuming. I don't actually know if they took that med kit or not, but I'm going to pretend they did so I can be pissed off about it. And, I don't think I want to upgrade anything else on these. Because none of this actually increases the damage it does. It just kind of increases the effectiveness of it, like how fast you can use it. And, I don't know, I just don't find it super useful. So.
Oh shit, get down, get down.
Damn!
No.
Brutal.
Busy couple of days, huh?
Whatever, man. Damn, no food. Old pair of shoes. We got nothing. Let's go.
Yeah, I know, Ellie. That was totally fucked. It's totally fucked. They just murdered those people for no reason. But, you know, if you guys need some food, I did see some grilled rats back there. They're up for grabs. I don't think those guys need them anymore. Anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this part. Not a whole lot of progress because that section takes a while, that combat section. But in the next part, we should get some fairly decent ground towards the bridge that we're heading towards. And you can bet there's going to be some more fucked up stuff happening. So look forward to that. I'm Dude Long Couch, and I hope to see you guys in the next part. Thanks for watching, guys. See ya.